Hey, what's up, everyone? This is Silver Slayer. Thank you for tuning in. Today, we're talking about why silver spot price is irrelevant. Before we start, make sure to smash that like button. Subscribe if you are new. I do post daily videos. So, anyways, why is silver spot price irrelevant? This goes into the idea of comparing it to the dollar. Now, if we're talking about a silver ETF, which I just mentioned in my last video, then it could be more relevant comparing it to like the stock market because it is an exchange traded fund and its monetary value is based off fiat currency on an exchange, traded on an exchange type basis. But we're talking about physical bullion, the physical precious metals, where its value, its real value, is in the actual metal content, the intrinsic value of the precious metals that you hold in your hand that is used in technology, in the industrial world, in the medical world. That's where, the real value is for physical precious metals. So if you're holding a 1 ounce coin, the spot price of that coin really doesn't matter. What matters is the ounce of silver that's inside of it that's used for technology. If you're looking at silver's price based on spot price, you're missing out on the bigger picture. If you can look at the bigger picture and see where its real value is, that's when you can really understand why we stack silver and gold, the physical form of it. Now, people that trade on, ETFs or trade on exchanges, there is money to be made, but I think that's a much different market. Physical bullion needs to be mined out of the ground. It needs to be stamped and minted for coins. It needs to be made into jewelry, made into electronics. We know silver is the most highly conductive metal for thermal conductivity and electricity. And these are beneficial factors and properties that any type of digital online exchange, whatever the case is, whether you're talking about stock markets, ETFs, option markets, futures contracts, it's a whole different category. It's a whole different world, a whole different ball game. And when you're looking at silver spot price, especially the people that analyze it every single day, and if it's down a couple pennies, freak out, that's you're gonna drive yourself insane. Us silver stackers, especially the long haulers, understand the real value of it, understand the bigger picture, and we're not worried about what spot price is. It's gonna go up, it's going to go down. That's the natural market of it. What we see is the potential, the undervalued aspect for its future, its long-term future in regards to 10, 20, 30 years when we need more of this metal in the everyday world, especially the technological age we're advancing into. So if you're one of those people that are looking at physical bullion as, something as the stock markets or trading every day and looking at the highs and lows and trying to buy and sell here, you're going to drive yourself crazy. And this is not the right market for you. Not saying there's not money to be made, because with any investment, there is money to be made. There are quick flippers. There are people that sell numismatic coins and can sell and buy and sell on eBay and find good deals. And that works. If it works for you, then go for it. But for someone to look at spot price and analyze it, looking at, especially like candlestick charts, which I've done in the past, but that's more for an educational purpose, trying to educate or trying to see where silver's near future price can go. But if you're looking at it for actual monetary purposes or investing purposes, it really is something that's irrelevant in my opinion. But I want people to understand the bigger picture with silver. Because even not even including it with gold, silver has so much potential in the future that even something like gold can seem like a silly investment. We're looking at gold's price right now around $1,450, comparing it to silver's price, which is $16.42. That's crazy. Back in Egyptian times, gold and silver held the same value. An ounce of silver was just as valuable as an ounce of gold because they understood the real value of silver. It only comes out of the ground roughly 9 to 1, not including all the silver that's lost in electronics after they're thrown away or damaged, comparing it to gold that's always remelted and re-scrapped. So really that ratio is a lot lower. So if you're looking at stuff like that, if you understand it, if you're getting educated, then you can start to see the bigger picture and see why and see where we're going with this. You don't have to put on your tinfoil hat to see that, or to rebel against silver, rebel against the dollar to be a silver stacker. That's not true. That's not the case. Silver has many intrinsic values. It's been used in medicine. It can be used in water purification. People have been using it for 6,000 years as a means for beneficial uses in an actual monetary value, actually longer than gold. Silver is actually the longest valued or asset that's ever been seen as money since mankind. Nothing else has ever been, nothing else even compares to it in lengths of people seeing it as a tradable currency. And there's a reason for that. And it's always going to be traded as a valued currency in the future as well, heading forwards. That's something to really think about because our financial system hasn't always worked and it's not always going to work. And it's actually failing a lot quicker than people realize. Whether you want to admit it or not, you're going to have to deal with the consequences when that time comes. Not saying what the solution is, not saying that silver is the solution, but it's definitely a way to secure yourself and protect yourself a little bit from the consequences that are going to be happening. It doesn't take a natural disaster, it doesn't take a tragic event for silver to boom. That is what, a lot of that is the factor that drives a lot of people into it because they feel more secure and safe controlling their own wealth. But, it really doesn't have to come down to that for you. Just being educated, just understanding the values can be a perfect way in. And, you don't have to be extremely educated and you don't have to know a lot about silver to start stacking it. I make a lot of beginner tutorial type videos where you can watch a video. I'll post links where to buy your silver safe and secure. I post videos how to store your silver, what type of capsules to put them in. What the best silver is to start if you're a beginner, how to budget your money, and so on and so forth. It really is all just justification and trying to just convince yourself that it's irrelevant or convince yourself that the market's never going to move. And that's comparing it to spot price again. And that's another thing that I see a lot of people do is when they look at silver, they or gold even. They compare it to a bear market because it's only fluctuated a couple dollars in the last so years. But that's still looking at the wrong picture. You're missing the whole idea of it. It's not about the spot price. It's not about how much the market's moved. It's about the intrinsic value of the metal content that's going to be saving yourself from hyperinflation because that's the real issue behind this is our dollars are depreciating. They're losing its purchasing power, so we need to put our money into something that holds its value, and that's where silver comes into. Even gold at that. Gold does have some beneficial properties that silver doesn't even have, like holding, you can hold a large amount of wealth in a small space with gold. Like you can fit $100,000 in a shoebox with gold. You cannot do that with silver. So there is some beneficial things that even that comes with gold over silver. And I'll admit that, I'm not trying to be a silver pumper. I definitely just see as realistic as possible and unbiased as possible, silver definitely makes the most sense in my eyes. And I'm sure it does with most of you guys as well. And that's why I try to promote this, and that's why I try to educate on this because I feel it's my duty, especially as my channel grows and I bring in new stackers to let them know why, and I definitely think you guys need to do your own research because you don't just listen to me, try to back up my stuff that I say with facts and evidence and proof and learn yourself and find articles, read articles, watch other YouTube videos, see what they have to say, question me. You can email me. I have an email, silverfiend21@gmail.com. You can email me, ask me questions. That's the quickest way to email me because usually it's kind of hard to keep up with all the questions on my videos. I talk to you guys all day long answering questions, sending each other links on deals and where to find good deals for pandas and questions about the markets and etc., video ideas, whatever it is. I'm trying to engage with you guys and interact and learn as much as I can because I don't know everything as well. I've learned a lot from you guys. You guys have taught me a lot over the past, couple years I've been making videos on here, and I'm grateful for that. And it also is humbling to remember that I'm always learning, even now till today. I'm still always learning new things about the market, new things about silver, new ways to invest, new stacking strategies, how to switch up my strategy, how to do everything. It's trying to become or trying to stay open-minded because the second that I start to become closed-minded, thinking I know everything, is the second I'm gonna start losing, control of not only my stack or my strategy or my budget or my finances, but my life as well. It's taught me a lot of life lessons, and I want to apply them to all aspects of my life, not only just the monetary, category of it, to say the least. But anyways, I thought this was an interesting category. I'm curious what you guys think about this. Do you guys watch spot price every day? Do you guys, do you get, does your stomach drop when you see silver's down a dollar or something, or does it really not bother you as much? I also think it might happen more with newer stackers watching the price every day, thinking it's going to explode overnight, you know, stuff like that. I think the older, the more, you know, the more satisfied stacker, or I guess not satisfied, but the longer stackers, the more conditioned stackers, that's the word. The more conditioned stackers kind of see the bigger picture, and they're more easy on silver's price. They don't really get as dramatic when it does drop or when it does rise because they're in it for the long haul as well, which is also a point I wanted to make. But anyways, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, make sure to smash that like button. And as always, check out some other videos. You'll see some links right there on the left side. Go check out those videos as well. Thanks for tuning in. This was Silver Slayer. I will see you guys soon. Peace.